Hello, Lakers Nation. Should the Lakers pick up Blake Griffin if he's waived by the Detroit Pistons? And if they do, would we then be obligated to use the term Blakers? Just throwing it out there. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Make sure you subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. And don't forget to come join us on Flick, where we're talking Lakers basketball all day, every day. Just use the link in the description below. All right, what is going on with the Detroit Pistons and Blake Griffin? Oh, man. Well, the Pistons have decided it doesn't make sense to continue to play Blake Griffin over some of their younger players. They are a rebuilding club, and so they have sent Blake home. No animosity there. They've told Blake, we're going to come to a resolution here. We will either trade you or we will buy you out. So let's explore the trade possibility first. Could the Lakers trade for him? No. The reason why is because Blake is making $36+ million this season and has a player option next season for $39 million. The Lakers simply can't match that in terms of salary going out. It would be extremely problematic to do that without losing all of your major pieces. You're not doing that. But will any team trade for him? Will any team realistically be willing to, one, trade for Blake Griffin, period? Do they want Blake Griffin? And then two, do they have salaries that will match that $36 million that he's making this season? Three, want to pay Blake Griffin $39 million next season because he has a player option that would pay him that? And four, have pieces that the Pistons actually want? I think all of those things are unlikely. Added all together, it's really tough to come up with a workable deal for Blake Griffin. I never say never. There's always ways to get things done in the NBA, but on the surface, it would appear very unlikely that the Pistons find a trade for him. So will they buy him out? That is a huge buyout. I mean, how much money is Blake really going to be willing to give back in order for the Pistons to just eat that salary? That in and of itself could be a major hurdle, but let's say they go that route and Blake does indeed get waived. Well, first and foremost, as an option for the Lakers, yeah, I think the Lakers would be in play. I think Blake would certainly like to go to the Lakers. He would like to go to a team that has a chance to win a championship, but does he make sense for the purple and gold? Well, I know for a lot of us, the knee-jerk reaction is, well, the Lakers just lost Anthony Davis. Just replace him with Blake Griffin for the time being. However, according to Adrian Wojnarowski, the Pistons aren't going to buy him out till after March 25th, which is the trade deadline. Makes a ton of sense. Most teams do not want to buy out a player until after the trade deadline. Why? Because you never know when a trade is going to pop up in the NBA. Maybe on March 24th, a deal falls into their laps where Blake's salary could have been useful. I know, unlikely. But there's that possibility there, and then they'd be kicking themselves that they bought him out and are now paying him to go play basketball somewhere else. That's what a buyout means, and they can't use that salary. So because of that, I don't see him getting bought out until after March 25th, which for a Lakers team that just lost Anthony Davis right now, yeah, he can't be that stopgap for you. Even if Blake were to get bought out at this moment, let's say he gets bought out today, the Lakers don't have room under the hard cap to add anybody until February 24th. That's when the veteran minimum salary will prorate enough to fit under the hard cap for the Lakers. So because of that, that means that you're talking about most likely, if we assume Anthony Davis comes back after the All-Star break, you're talking about maybe four games that you would have Blake filling in for Anthony Davis before you would have AD back on the active roster. So is that really worth it? I think you can make an argument that Blake Griffin would be the most talented player on the buyout market this season, but does he fit? Not really. See, here's the thing. We think of Blake Griffin and we think of the Blake Griffin from his Clippers days, the guy who was dunking all over everybody, flying all over the court. He's not that guy anymore. And Lakers fans, we might have an even more inflated view of Blake because we just saw one of his best performances when he played against the Lakers. He turned in one of his best performances of the season, but he is not that guy. In fact, just to underscore this, he has not dunked the ball this season. That's right. He doesn't have a single dunk so far this season, and he is shooting 36% from the field, 31% from three, and scoring just 12.3 points. Yeah, he's not the same guy. Even on the boards, 5.2 rebounds per game right now, 3.9 assists. The guy can still pass the ball, but he is not the big bruising player that we've been looking for on this Lakers team. We've been saying for a while that they could use another rim protector. Blake is not that. On this season, he has blocked two shots. And defensively, he's been pretty much lit up. He is a net negative everywhere on the floor. Now, you can make the argument that Blake on the Lakers would be a very different player than Blake on the Pistons, and I do think that's a real thing. Sometimes you see players that are on bad teams that are being asked to do too much, and when they go to a good team, their role is simplified and they become much more effective. I think we would see that happen with Blake Griffin. I also think that he would have the mental boost. He would play harder for the Lakers because they would have a chance to win. That's just a natural thing. But I don't know that that's enough to mitigate the fit issues. Just to illustrate, let's say, and I'm not saying this is going to happen, but let's say Robin Lopez for the Washington Wizards gets bought out. Pretty much exactly what the Lakers need. Kind of a role player for his career, just a standard big man, can protect the rim a little bit, has a little bit of a back-to-the-basket game, that type of player. And Blake Griffin is bought out. Which one would you rather have on the Lakers? We're talking about a former superstar in Blake Griffin compared to a guy who has been a role player for his entire career in Robin Lopez. Which one is the better fit? Lopez certainly is. Now, maybe you can argue Blake Griffin has the higher ceiling, but which one would you rather have become a Laker? And the fact that you can even argue that, right? You can make a compelling argument for either side, shows you just how bad the fit would be with Blake Griffin. Now, perhaps come playoff time, Marc Gasol's minutes go down to zero and the Lakers just tell Anthony Davis he's their center and that's it. And then Blake Griffin could absorb Marc Gasol's minutes and you can play him alongside AD. That's a possibility. And I think the Lakers would have to be convinced of that working for them to go after Griffin. So I understand why, as soon as the news came out about Blake Griffin, we had Lakers fans everywhere saying, oh, go add him. We had people speculating that the Lakers would be high on the priority list for Blake Griffin if he is released by the Pistons. It makes sense when you see the Lakers lose Anthony Davis to say, hey, this guy could come in and take over some of those minutes. But again, logistically, it becomes a lot more difficult. He wouldn't really be around for much of the time that AD is out, if at all, particularly if the Pistons really do wait until after March 25th to buy him out. And then in terms of what this Lakers team needs right now, he's not necessarily a great fit. Now, I will say this, though. I know I've been overall pretty negative about adding Blake Griffin. I do think his talent level is still very high, and I do think he has another level he can get to if he was with the Lakers. I mean, look, there is a history of former very, very good to star-level players who wind up later in their careers going to a team that sort of revitalizes them. I mean, look at Dwight Howard last season, Nicholas Batum right now with the Clippers. We've seen this happen time and time again. I don't know how much of an impact that would make with Blake, but I do think that if he's there on the buyout market and you have a need at that point, and maybe that's Anthony Davis is out, maybe it's Kuzma, something else is going on, the Lakers have decided Anthony Davis is going to play the five permanently, whatever is happening. If they decide that is a real need, I think in terms of ceiling, in terms of upside, you're probably not going to find much better on the buyout market than Blake Griffin. So I wouldn't be totally against it, but as of right now, the fit is certainly questionable, and he also is not going to be out there to fill in for Anthony Davis and get the Lakers through these next few weeks without him. But let me know what you guys think. Is this a guy the Lakers should target, or is the fit so poor and or his game regressed so much that you just want nothing to do with it? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Don't forget, come join us on Flick by using the link in the description. And if you guys want to follow me on social media, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at TrevorLaneNBA on Instagram and Facebook. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.